And welcome to another edition of Beer Dad's Beer Reviews with me, Dave the Beer Dad, back again for another swipe at a beer review. Went to the Glenafric taproom yesterday, hence me wearing this rather natty Glenafric t-shirt. I was a little bit worried, if I'm being honest with you, because of the scathing reviews I've done of Glenafric beers. But taproom was really nice, it's a really good place, it's light, it's airy, it's nice. 20 odd beers on tap, ranging from sours at low end ABVs to impales up to sort of into 10s and 12s and stuff. Really good evening there. Before that I was at Gallagher's in Birkenhead, where I had Titanic's Anchor beer. Very much like the seems to be that the base of the plum porter that they do, but then just throw the fruit in obviously. And then before that was in Molly's Chamber. I'm drinking Revisionist Craft Lager. Anyway, so yeah, if you get a chance, if you're over in the Wirral, or if you're in Liverpool, you have a fancy little trip out, or even just in the area of holiday, try the Glenafric Tap Room. It's really good. The beers on the tap are better than what you're getting out the can, and I thought that would be the case, to be fair. So anyway, moving on to this review. This is a Beavertown beer. I've done Beavertown for a while. I just randomly picked them up every now and again. I saw this one in Barton's in Ashton Makefield, and it is the We Can Do Wit, a white IPA with coriander, grapefruit and lemon zest. And again, typical Beavertown art really, everything based around the skull. Very shiny can, very nice can, and that is what literally attracted me to picking this up. Cost me £3.25, we've got a canned on, and we've also got a best before here, so let's have a little look. So it was canned on the 29th of March, and the best before is the 29th of September, both this year. There it is. It is, ABV wise, 4.7%. Again, it says so, just round about there at the top. Like I say, not done a town in any great length. Let's pop a top and let's see what we've got. Okay, so there we go, beer in a glass then. We've got ourselves a slightly cloudy, almost see-through, light gold colour. Looks quite nice. Into two fingers of densely compact white. There's a little bit of carbonation there, but really small, tiny bubbles. But that looks quite good. Let's get a nose, see what we can smell. Yeah, it's grapefruit is there, some grapefruit is up front. Grapefruit peel. Not getting much else. Picking up any of the coriander. I'm not picking up any of the lemongrass. Because it's grapefruit dominant. Okay, let's go for the taste. Light to medium body, carbonation is sharp, flavour, there's not much there, a bit of the grapefruit comes through, there's a little bit of spiciness from the coriander. Not getting any of the lemongrass at all. It's pleasant. It's really pleasant. It's pleasant. It's no great earth mover. There's a little, little spicy tingle at the back end. Other than that, there's not a great deal to this beer. That's at 4.7, it's not bad. Yeah, it's just standard. Watery, light IPA, bit more, bit of grapefruit in it, spicy finish. Don't get any of the lemon zest.
Okay.
It's alright. Do I like it? Yeah, it's nice. Would I buy it again? Probably not. It's nice, but I've had it, I wouldn't buy it again. Would I recommend it to friends? Yeah, I would. So there you go. So, if you've had this beer, let me know what you think. Put a little comment below. Do the thumbs up if you like the beer. If you like the review, thumbs down if you don't. Link to the Beer Town website below. And you can buy the stuff off them. And that's pretty much it. See you in the next one. Hail.